Hi everyone, I am R.V. Kiran, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering. In this video lecture, I am going to discuss the construction method of parabola, that is directrix focus method. This method is also known as general method also. So there are two names for it, directrix focus method and general method, which we use to see in the engineering drawing subject. So this is the last construction method of the parabola curve. So parabola is an open curve compared to the ellipse. So ellipse is a closed curve. So going to the construction of directrix method, it have an eccentricity. So we have already discussed about eccentricity in the ellipse construction method. There also we have discussed in the general method. So for general methods purpose, the eccentricity is taken as norms. So for the ellipse, the eccentricity is less than 1, and for parabola it is equal to 1, that is E is equal to 1. So we are taking the same length of the vertex as center. So the total length of the focus line have been divided into two equal parts, that is center is vertex. This is the question for the directrix focus method for construction of a parabola. So the problem is, point F is 50 mm from a vertical straight line AB. Draw locus of point P moving in a plane such that it always remains equidistant from the point F and line AB. So this is the question for the construction of directrix focus method. We have to identify the objects here. So what are the objects? So they have clearly defined about the vertex point. So in the second line, you have, when you have studied that, draw locus of point P moving in a plane such that it always remains equidistant from point F. So F is the focus here, and the vertex is equidistant from the directrix and focus point. So this is on the center of the focus line, and it is equidistant from the AB line, that is directrix line and point F. F means focus here. Then in the question, focus length is given as 50 mm from the vertical straight line AB. So from the directrix line, it is given as 50 mm length. So first of all, we have to draw a vertical straight line AB. So name it as AB. And this is the required directrix line. Then draw a horizontal line perpendicular to the directrix line. So perpendicular to AB, we have drawn a line, and the center is defined as O here, and take 50 mm from the center O in the horizontal line and name it as F, that is focus. So we have named it as F, focus. So the length of the OF line is 50 mm. Then take the vertex point at the center of the focus line, that is at 25 mm you have to take the vertex point and name it as V. So name it as V. So it is equidistant from the directrix line as well as the focus point also. Earlier in the eccentricity method of ellipse, we have divided the focus line into number of equal parts, that is 5 number of equal parts, and the second part is the vertex. But here It is equidistant from the focus and the line AB, that is the directrix line. Then take 5 mm from 5 mm of each part from the vertex line and draw a vertical lines on each part, that is 1 2 3 4. So take 5 mm from the vertex point on the right side of vertex and divide equally, that is each part is 5 mm. So you can take it as 10 mm, 15 mm, and your own choice that. So based upon your choice, you have take these equidistance parts. So I have taken it as 5 mm only. So to the right side of the vertex, I have divided these parts 1 2 3 4 into 5 mm equidistance lines and draw a vertical lines to it. Then take O1 as length. So from the center of the directrix line O and to the first divided part 1, so take O1 as length and F as center. So taking focus as center and O1 as length, draw an arc on the first vertical line on the upward and downward section. So it is indicated as P1 and P2. So similarly, take these points to the other sections also, so other lines also. So we have named it as P1 and P2. Next, take O2 as length, so center of the directrix line O and second part of the divided lines, two divided points. So O2 as length and F as center. So take again F as center and draw an arc on the second vertical line, that is second point vertical line. We have obtained other 2 points, one on the upward of the focus line and downward, one on the downward of the focus line, one on the upside and on the downside of the focus line. Name it as P3, P4 and repeat this order for the next points also, that is O3, O4 and other points also. So take O3 as length and F as center, cut an arc on the third vertical line. We have obtained other 2 points, one on the upside and then the other on the downside, and take O4 as length and F as center, draw arcs on the fourth divided line. We have obtained other 2 points. So these arcs can be drawn with the help of the compass only, not on freehand. So some students have drawn it on freehand, but the order is to draw it on the compass only. So joining all these points with the vertex, we have obtained a curve here. So this is the required parabola. So the center is the center of the curve is gone through the vertex only, and the curve is named as parabola. So this is the required curve and it is parabola. So name the other points as P3, P4, P5, P6, P7, P8 of your required order. So this is the required directrix focus method of parabola, which we have obtained a curve, locus curve. So I am repeating the construction once more. So first of all draw the directrix line, that is AB, that is the vertical straight line. Name it as AB and denote a center to it, a midpoint, and draw the focus line of length 50 mm. So draw a vertical line of 50 mm and end point is F, that is focus. And next put a midpoint, locate a midpoint of vertex V exactly at the center of the focus line, which is of 25 mm length. Name it as V. Then divide equidistance points from vertex, right side of the vertex. I have taken it as 5 mm. So draw a vertical lines from all those points. Then taking O1 as length, F as center, draw an arc on the upside and downside of the focus line. Name it as P1, P2. Then take O2 as length and F as center and draw an arc on the second vertical line. Name it as P3, P4 and draw it to the remaining two points also. So you have to take your own choice. So I have taken it as 5 mm. You may take it as 10 mm, 7 mm, 8 mm of your own choice. So I have taken it for the next points also. Same process it is done for the next points also. And I have obtained a curve which is going through vortex V point, and this is the required parabola line. So this is the required parabola line, and it is also called as locus. So this is the construction of the directrix focus method. It is also known as general method also, and the procedure for the general method is here. So locate center of the line of the perpendicular to AB from point F. This will be initial point P and also the vertex. So mark 5 mm distance to its right side. So name those points 1, 2, 3, 4, and from those lines draw lines parallel to AB. So we are drawing lines parallel to the directrix line AB. So mark 5 mm distance to its left of P and name it as 1. So take O1 distance as radius and F as center. Draw an arc cutting first parallel line to AB, that is first line. Name upper point as P1 and lower point as P2. So since FP1 is equal to O1, so FP1 means the distance between the F and focus from P1 point is equal to O1. Similarly, repeat this process by taking again 5 mm to right side and left side and locate P3 point and P4 point. So I have taken 4 points here. So when we have to, this is an open curve. When we take any number of equal points, but the curve obtained is same, not a closed one, it is an open one. So the height of the curve will be increasing by increasing the points of the vertical lines. So division of the points from the vertex, when we increase the division of the points from the vertex, the length of the curve may also increase. So I have taken 4 points. You have taken, you may take up to 5 to 6 points. So that is the limit. And the division of the points, the distance of marking is, I have taken as 5 mm. You may take of your own choice, that is 6, 7 mm, say 8 mm, 10 mm, 15 mm of your own choice. And similarly repeat this process by taking again 5 mm to right and left and locate P3 and P4. So then repeat the same order, same process for the remaining points also, and join all these points in a smooth curve. It will be locus of P, equidistance from the line AB and fixed point F. So the fixed point, the equidistance point is called vertex here, which is denoted as V. So that is equidistance from the directrix line AB and fixed point F. So the curve is passing through this vertex point only. So this is the general procedure for the general method. So by now I have explained all the three construction methods of the parabola, which is in the test book also, engineering drawing test book. As per this syllabus, I have explained all the construction methods for parabola. First one is the rectangle method, that is also known as oblong method, and second one is the tangent method, and last one is the directrix focus method, which is also known as general method. So these are the basic constructions for those methods, construction methods for drawing parabola. Thank you.